Hey everybody, it's me, John Ward, and this is going to be a little bit of an experiment for me. I've never done one of these videos before. This is kind of going to be like a travel video. I am going to be seeing today the Monkees in concert for the 100th time. I've seen every tour that they've done since 1986. Never missed a tour. I've even driven 5 hours to go see them to make sure that I've never missed a tour. And so today I'll be driving out to California, Riverside, and catching what they're calling is their farewell tour. I'm hoping it's not their farewell tour. I'm hoping it's not the last thing of the Monkees. I've been a fan of them since I was 10 years old. I've been a dedicated fan and been through them with the, you know, ups and downs of their careers. I've met them all. I've supported everything they've done, good and bad. That's how much of a fan I am. So we're in September. My birthday was September 10th, which was last Friday. And now I'm heading out this Friday, today, and going to see them. It's great. They always seem to tour sometime in September. So I always kind of look at that as a like a birthday concert. So this is it. I mean, this could be the end. So who knows? I hope not. They'll probably do a bunch of solo stuff and do tours solo. And who knows, maybe another album, you know, fingers crossed on that one. But today I am, you know, before I leave, I'm actually listening to the Monkees, which I'll turn this right here. There we go. And this album is a little weird. It says it's the greatest hits of the Monkees, but it's a live album, which I guess is fine. In concerts, they play the greatest hits, but it's a little misleading from the, the album cover and what's written there. But that's fine. I mean, I can listen to them live since I'm seeing them live. And I have my Monkees Mug Ojo. So I'm pretty much set, you know, got my ticket ready and all that. So I'm going to try and document this and see what happens. This could be a short video. It could be a long video. I don't know. But I'm going to kind of see what happens throughout the day and just chronicle along the way. I think that they'll allow us to record a little bit inside at the concert. I've already seen on YouTube one of the tours from like a couple nights ago. There's already about like 20 minutes worth of video up. So it looks like they're okay with it. So I'll try that and see what happens. So, yeah, I mean, just a little bit of a history. I was introduced to the Monkees when I was 10 years old. They had a big reunion because that was their 10-year anniversary. The show was 1966. And so basically in 1976, 77, there was a big kind of revival. The show was brought back and basically for like kids and like new like re-releases of albums, greatest hits, things like that were brought out, bootlegs. And two of the Monkees, Mickey and Davey, and two of the writers, Tommy Boyce and Bobby Hart, joined forces and create a band called Dolan's Jones, Boyce and Hart. They could not use the Monkees' name because of copyright issues. And they went out on tour, sung a bunch of Monkees songs, sung some just Tommy Boyce and Bobby Hart songs. The tour was a huge success. Huge. The album bombed. The TV special was never broadcast. I think the album was pretty good. As you know, it felt like just a 70s Monkees album. And then, of course, in the 80s, there was the 1986 reunion and MTV. Once again, boom, huge. Pretty much made MTV what they are today. And they showed all the episodes. The Monkees were guests. Mike Nesmith even showed up once or twice. And, huge tours and everything. So, and that's when it started for me all over again is even though I enjoyed their music and watched the old TV show, I can now see them live. And it was in September, and which was basically around my birthday, which is when they normally toured in my area, which is great, and went to go see them at Marriott's Great America in California. Dave Kitsilla was there, who's a friend of mine, and Scott Johnson, who's my friend, and they're both on Facebook, so, you know, hey guys, if you're watching this. And we went, and I've always kind of brought friends with me to these shows until I moved, and so it's one of those things where, you know, I've even brought my friend like Jeff Gordon with me, and another friend at the time, like Mitch Glane, and just always tried to, you know, Noreen Kaur, you know, a bunch of people. So it was always kind of a thing that I would do with other people. But then once I moved, it came, pretty much became more like a solo thing. I've always watched them solo. I've tried to catch as many concerts as possible. I've seen each Monkey in concert at least once or twice. I think I've seen Nesmith now maybe three times, Peter Tork twice, Davy Jones once, Mickey I think I've seen twice. So I'm hoping they'll continue touring solo and continue bringing out albums, and maybe we'll get something down the road as far as the Monkees go. But, you know, as you... Oh, now we're hitting into the actual songs, so I guess they were just playing some live stuff instead of the actual songs. So now this is an actual studio recording. But, yeah, so that's it. I don't want to go on too long with this. But, yeah, I'll try to chronicle this and then put it up on the Dark Park Films YouTube channel. And I hope that you enjoy it. And, yeah, so I'll see you on the road. Hey, everybody. I am pretty much ready to go. So now I just, you know, have some spare time. So I thought that I would watch the Monkees' 1968 film, Head. This is a film that they made after the show was canceled. The show was two seasons, and they went out and made a movie. The film, when it came out, tanked. It bombed horribly. And which is not surprising if you know the movie, if you've seen it. This is aimed at teeny boppers, or is supposed to be aimed at teeny boppers, but it really isn't. Teeny boppers were confused. Adults were confused. It's directed by Bob Raffleson. It is produced by Bob Raffleson and Bert Schneider. It is written by Rob Raffleson, Bert Schneider, the Four Monkees, and Jack Nicholson. Jack Nicholson is also one of the producers on it. He is the music supervisor, and he did a lot of research by following the Monkees around to kind of see what this whole Monkey thing is about. So this is kind of a deconstruction of the band and how they felt trapped in this kind of prefabricated role. And because once it came out that they, you know, were known for not playing all their instruments or not writing all their songs, they were known as the Prefab Four. And that kind of stuck with them for a while. The Fab Four being the Beatles, the Prefab Four being the Monkees. So this kind of goes through what they went through. And it is definitely a strange movie. Like I said, it's called Head. I would imagine that's because you need to be high while watching it. And there's a ton of Easter eggs and stuff like that in here, especially if you know the Monkees. They open this film in a very kind of bizarre way. And I'm actually going to just, you know, kind of talk through this beginning here, because this is no way to begin a movie that's considered to be for families and teenagers. And there's Mickey Dolenz, there's the rest of the Monkees, there's, you know, Mike, Davey, Peter, and this is technically the end of the movie. So it begins where it ends, and then it ends where it begins, type of thing. So it's, they're running on this bridge, and Mickey hops up on the railing there and jumps. So in the first maybe three or four minutes of the movie, one of the monkeys commits suicide. I mean, what? How? So you can kind of understand why the film might have bombed, but today it's now known as a cult classic. Rob Zombie is a big fan of the monkeys and the movie. Edgar Wright is also a big monkeys fan. When he actually does his like screenings, when he normally goes around with a couple movies and shows them to audiences, Head is one of them. He loves Head. He's a big monkeys fan. And if you remember in Scott Pilgrim versus the World, one of the bands in the Battle of the Bands, their drum is labeled as drum, which later on in this film, when the monkeys are performing live, Mickey's drum says drum. And then in the 90s, he brought that back. So when they would go out on tour and when they would do music videos, his drum would just say drum. That's from Head. That's from Edgar Wright. You know, of course, Edgar Wright got it from them. So it kind of comes full circle. Mickey Dolenz was in Rob Zombie's remake of Halloween. And you can hear some like clips from Head from old White Zombie albums. The God of Thunder EP has Mike Nesmith's voice on it. So he's a fan too. There's, as I'm sure, oh, Mark Hamill. I just posted recently a meme from Mark Hamill saying that they're probably the most underrated band ever. So a lot of people like these guys, and they're definitely underrated. So I just thought it would be fun to show you the beginning of this very confusing film. And if you have a chance, watch it. It's on YouTube. Just look up, you know, Monkey's Head 1968. I believe the version that's on there is the Criterion version, which means it's got a really nice, clear picture. And check it out. You know, even check it out high. You know, get drunk or something. Watch it with a group of people because it's got a ton of music in it. It's really well done. There's celebrity cameos in it, which I'm not going to mention because I'll let that be a surprise. So I hope you enjoy it, and I will talk to you in a little bit. Bye. Hey, all right, I'm in the car. I'm ready to go. I got music. Looking a little cloudy out there. Hopefully it doesn't rain. Don't like driving in the rain. Cloudy is okay. Wind's okay. Just don't like the rain. So I am ready to go. It took me about 4 hours to get to Riverside and to the theater. And you might ask, what music do I have playing? You would maybe think it was the Monkees or something like that. After all, I'm going to see the Monkees, so why wouldn't it be the Monkees? Or maybe that's too much. Maybe going to the tour, listening to the Monkees, and then seeing them live might be too much. So I actually got, I'll be listening to, Six Degrees of Separation type of thing. An artist that I had mentioned in the previous video. And let's find out who that is. All right, so let's find out who this mystery artist is. Might be kind of obvious, but let's see who it is. Yep, we got some White Zombie playing, some Rob Zombie. So that's going to be my my music playing for my trip, at least to the Monkees. Not sure what I'll be listening to on the way back, but I will be listening to this for the next 4 hours. It's every Rob Zombie album, every White Zombie album. I got rarities. I got a whole ton of stuff on here. So there's about, I don't know, 4.5 hours worth of music on here. So including the new album from Rob Zombie. So, all right. Yeah. So I think that's was my cue to go. All right, here we go.
Looks like I got through some traffic, picked up a package at work, which is the coffee that I've been waiting for my sponsor. Got some Rob Zombie going here. Well, actually, well, White Zombie, to be more precise. Heading out of Vegas now. Looks like we might have, you know, might have had to have some rain, but that's clearing up. And like to get into that carpool lane. Wonder if I brought my skeleton with me, if that would have worked as my passenger. Never know. Maybe. Maybe not. No. It's all up in the air. So, yeah, this is heading out of Vegas. There's the Bellagio. You got the Mandalay Bay. You got some new stuff being built. So, all right, well, I'll check in a little bit later. Here we go. There's we're coming up here on the border, Nevada-California border. We got Whiskey Peaks over there. Over there. There was another casino that I just passed. We got an outlet mall. Coming up on the sign here that says "Welcome to California." All right, I'm now in California.
Welcome to California.
Oh, even my phone welcomed me to California, so how nice of it. So, all right, so I'll catch you a little bit later. Okay, so I've had to make a pit stop. It's normally the rest stop that I always stop at when I'm going to California. Hopefully this will be the only one. I'm getting older, so that means more pit stops, but I'm hoping only one pit stop on this trip. Just went over this gigantic hill, or mountain, actually, and my car just does not like it. It's just one of those, it's kind of like the Grapevine. It's just huge, and found out that my AC's not working very well, so I'm hoping the further west I go, the cooler it will get. I'm having to keep the window down. Right now it is sprinkling, so I don't know. Maybe I will get some rain, but yeah, be back on the road in a couple of minutes. This is actually a pretty nice rest stop. Windy, sprinkling a little bit. Okay, this is not allowed in here. I just went in and used the restroom. I came out 1 minute later and it is pouring rain. What's going on? This is the one thing I do not like driving in. Quickly make it through this rain.
Hopefully it doesn't stay like this. All right, not so bad here. All right, I'm safely inside the car. I will talk with you later. We are now in Baker. And Baker is the home of the world's largest thermometer. Let's see if I can get a shot of that. Yep, there it is in the distance. And it looks like it's working. Right now, according to my car, it's 103 degrees. So let's see if this actually gives us a temperature. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's that large thing sticking up with lights on it. It's up to, let's see, so 98 degrees according to the thermometer. We are going past it. And that's about the extent of what you can see in Baker. Got a couple of cool places with some palm trees by it, but otherwise, not much. So coming up here on the right is an old abandoned waterslide park. Some short films, some commercials, music videos were shot here. I've been out here at least 3 or 4 times, just kind of cruising around. I wanted to shoot a film out here, but the insurance was too expensive, so I couldn't do it. When I first saw this place, it was beautiful. There was no graffiti, nothing was burnt. It was literally like people just disappeared. All the paperwork was there, desk chairs, containers for like Coke and all that were there, and now it's just junk. It's all graffiti. It sucks so much compared to what it used to be. I think it would still be cool to shoot here. but I don't know anymore. It's just not the same. But this is about 2 hours out from Vegas. So it's about the midpoint between Vegas and L.A. And then all this barbed wire here used to be like a lake for the park. And that's about it. So, all right. So about halfway there. We're about to enter Barstow. I spent a couple nights here coming back from California when I was just too exhausted from concerts. So this is Barstow. They got this cool train coming up. This is also where, if you've seen Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas, the Johnny Depp film where he plays Hunter S. Thompson, this is the place where he says, Barstow, that's where the drugs kicked in. So now you're, if you haven't been here, but you've seen that movie, this is it. Just kind of let this, I'm going to let this record until we go under the train, because I like the train. The train's kind of cool. Barstow Station over there. Trains are cool. All right, and that's Barstow. So I will check in again in a little bit. Stuck in a mess of traffic. It's not horrible. Could be worse. Still traffic. GPS shows that it's going to be like this for a while, so. All right, lightening up a little bit now. Okay, all right, getting a little better. Okay. All right, a little better. All right, okay. Have no idea what that was all about. Really bad traffic, and then now it's okay for the most part. All right, check in later.
Well, I got here pretty early, and now I am eating at a Denny's. I like Denny's, and they have the Grand Slam, the Lumberjack Grand Slam. And I am having that right now. So kind of just wasting time here until the doors open at the theater, which is about 9 minutes away. And yeah, pretty much that's where I'm at right now. So we got some elevator music going. It's actually kind of nice in here. It's not very busy. It's nice just to kind of cool off because it was hot in the car because of the air conditioning. And letting my body cool down, eating some food, which I think I needed, and just kind of hanging out and waiting a little bit longer until I have to go. Alrighty, so that was pretty good. I've always liked Denny's, and they were pretty cool with letting me hang out for a little bit.
I did check to see if there was a Dollar Tree around, and there's one just down the block. So that's where I'm going to be headed off to now. I'll check out Dollar Tree, see if the California Dollar Trees are any different than the... Oh! Okay. See if the Dollar Trees in California are any different than the Dollar Trees in Las Vegas. Fair amount of traffic through here. Guy was on a motorcycle. So, yeah. So I'm going to go check that out. And then I will tune back in with you guys just a little bit later. Okay, so just went into Dollar Tree, and they do not have any movies. They don't carry movies. I don't know. Place looks bigger than most Dollar Trees. It's got a lot of people in there. They already have Christmas stuff. Could not find any, like, Halloween mugs. That kind of bummed me out, too. But, yeah, this is the... see if we go. There we go. The Dollar Tree that does not carry movies. And that's, I don't know, kind of silly. That stuff is very popular with them, so, but oh well. So I guess now I'll head over and try to find parking close to the concert, and kind of disappointed in Dollar Tree. They have let me down. That bums me out, but, you know, what are you going to do? And, yeah, so I guess that's it. So I will check in with you guys a little bit later. The car in front of me does not have his lights on. I would flash them, but then they may think it's a gang thing and try to kill me. I know how these things work. Okay, so I made it to the Fox Riverside Theater, and I'm gonna go inside. Busy street. Don't see any marquee, might be on the other side. But I will see. Well, I misjudged this line. I figured that there would only be maybe 20 people, 30 people, but this thing goes down about 2 blocks. Longest line I've ever seen for the Monkees. So,
there is a wait. Luckily, the show does not start until 8 o'clock. Well, I made it inside. I am sitting down, and everybody is wearing a mask. And showtime has been delayed because there's so many people here. And hopefully the show will start soon, but I understand if they wait, because there are a ton of people here, this place might be sold out. So, this is pretty amazing. This is pretty full. So very exciting. Unfortunately, they did not have coffee mugs. They did not have posters. They had nothing that I wanted to buy for this last concert. So that kind of bums me out. But what are you going to do? So you can only buy what they have. And I didn't feel like spending money on something that I didn't want. So, yeah, that's where that is there. And I'm going to check back in once the other show is going.
I really love doing this album, produced by the incredible Mr. Christian Nesmith. And one of the songs I did on the album is, I'm going to tell you a little story about it that Nez told me. This is one of the first songs that Nez wrote, and early days, early Monkey days, and he went into the producers and said, "I want to sing you a little song."
Not quite like it. I got a song I wrote, and I could sing it, and we could have Mickey sing it. But it's I think it's cute. Do you like the song? And he said, "No."
That's right. They said, he played the song, they said, "No, it's not a monkey song." And he said, "Wait a minute, I am one of the monkeys." And they said, "Yeah, thank you, no thank you. We'll call you, don't call us." So he went away and he gave it to a young girl singer who was kicking around Los Angeles at the time. And the rest is history. Her name was Linda Ronstadt. This is Different Drum. ago, decades ago, we had the pleasure of going to England on tour, and there we met the members of the royal family.
Bob, Will,
not, not that royal family, the Beatles. Yeah. And one night, they threw us a party.
They threw us out of the party.
No. Well, that's true. But they threw us a party. I'm told I had a great time.
You did.
And I went back to my hotel room and I wrote a little song that I called Grandy Scouts Get. About my experiences. I didn't know what it meant, an English term. I found out later that it meant a horny Liverpudlian putz.
Place like the basement, and you're down there, and then all horses mean. And what it means is we're off on a journey. We don't know where it goes. It's going somewhere. And we're on the back of it. We might as well get used to it. And what's one of the ladies in the exec suite? And he said, well, you know, Mike, Monkees fans don't want a song to cry to. I said, bullshit.
This next one I really love. This was written by Paul Weller and Noel Gallagher. Birth of an Accidental Hist.
Thank you. I just got out of the Monkees concert, and once again, they were really good. This is their final tour. And these guys are, you know, pretty old now, and what they could still do on stage was pretty impressive. So I'm happy. The crowd really seemed to like it. Seemed to be almost sold out, and yeah. So I'm glad I came. You know, the concert was supposed to be almost 2 years ago, and it got postponed because of COVID. But yeah, really enjoyed it, and glad that I came. And I guess that's really about it. So, you know, the show was really good. They played a whole bunch of, you know, old stuff, new stuff, and somewhere in between. So I'm pretty happy, and I'm a little self-conscious about recording in front of the
the place because people keep walking by me and staring at me. So I'm going to say goodbye for now. Bye.
Hey, doing this video because the last one kind of made me nervous. People were staring at me and looking at me, and you know, here I am talking to my phone, and this isn't something that I normally do. So I just got gas for the trip back, sitting in the gas station parking lot, and thought I would do a better video than the one that that I did. It's kind of dark out here, so I look, I think, a little spooky. But basically, this is it. This closes a lifelong chapter of my life. I started liking the Monkees when I was 10. Very dedicated to them, and just always stuck with them through thick and thin, and you know, good and bad, I was there supporting it, and I think that's the one way that you could tell a true fan is when they can actually pick out the good and the bad. You know, I don't think that you're a true fan if just everything is good. You got to be able to say, you know, when something was not as good, or that you hoped better. But with the Monkees now, this is it. My first concert was in 1986, and I have not stopped. I've driven 5 hours to see them, and when I say literally, I actually mean literally. I have literally seen every single tour since 1986, and obviously, that does not mean I went to every concert. That just means that I went to one or two shows per tour that they were on. And now we're 2001, and this is, you know, for them it's 55 years. For me, it's like, you know, 35 years, and that I've been a dedicated fan. So this pretty much ends that chapter in my life. I did enjoy the show. I liked it. You know, some shows are better than others. I wouldn't call this their best show. I think those shows are behind them. And, you know, Nesmith, unfortunately, is, you know, had to sit in a chair most of the show. He had to use a cane. His voice just wasn't there. And, you know, I think that this is probably a good thing that this is their final tour. I respect them for doing this. This was put off from almost 2 years ago, you know, when COVID hit. And we've been waiting, the fans have been waiting for this show. So maybe the show would have been different 2 years ago. But Nesmith just seems very frail. Mickey held the show together. He still has that voice. You know, he can hit all of those high notes and I'm a Believer and some of his other songs. You know, I respect them going out and doing this farewell tour and not canceling when they could have. It was great seeing them one last time. And even though I would have preferred to have, you know, Mickey on drums, which he wasn't. He wasn't on guitar, and normally he kind of goes between the two. He was mostly like tambourine, maracas, and Mike was in a chair most of the time. He did get up for a little bit. He had to use a cane, you know, to and from the stage. Some of the times he did need help. So I didn't know that his health was like that. I don't know if he's in bad health. I'm not sure about, but because on Facebook he did report that he's, you know, got the A+ from his doctor, which is why, you know, he was able to do the tour. So they did play a lot of their hits. They played some songs that a lot of people, if this is their first time watching, they wouldn't know the songs. I do. It was a scaled down show. They didn't have up the video screens. They didn't have a lot of the lights. They didn't have a lot of that stuff. So it was pretty much just the bare necessities to put on the show. I think at times too many instruments, kind of just everything gets kind of jumbled into like a big mess. And this might be one of those cases. Even though I did think that they sounded good,
I think maybe there were just too many instruments, too many background singers. I remember when the Monkees did go out, just when it was three of them, and they did have a backup band, but the band was in the background and they were up front. Sometimes it was difficult to hear people singing. But I'm glad I went to the show. I won't forget it. It means a lot to me. You know, it's just one of those things that, you know, I'm hoping that they do solo stuff. I don't think Nesmith will be touring anymore. Mickey probably will. He was dancing around and doing stuff, so he still seems okay, even at his age. And I'm 54, so they're, you know, 20 years older than me, give or take. So they're somewhere in their 70s. And they're still out there singing. They're still doing pretty good. So I basically just wanted to make this video because now I feel a little more comfortable sitting in my car. And I'm about to head back to Vegas. Not sure how much I'll be filming while I'm driving out to Vegas, because it's just going to be dark and there's going to be no light and nothing to see. So, but I'll see. If not, then, and you're watching this video, I do appreciate it. I really do. And now I can look forward to, you know, other things in life. I'm hoping that Rhino does put out more albums, you know, deluxe editions and things like that. So I hope, you know, the Monkees as a group or solo just don't completely go away. I think that there's still more stuff to, you know, that they could do, just not tour. But, you know, it's all kind of up in the air right now. And as I'm sure COVID is a concern, and age and all that. So I guess that's about it. I don't want to keep rambling on. I need to get going right now. It is, what time is it? It is 11:10. I was not expecting to be leaving this late. I'll say this last thing and then I'll go. The concert had a huge line, so they delayed it. So it was supposed to start at 8. It started more like around 8:20, 8:30. It was weird. They did have an intermission in it, which maybe was for Nez and Mickey to, you know, to go pee or something. But it's for a concert that's not over 2 hours. It's kind of weird to have a 20-minute intermission. You know, and then they came back and they did, you know, they played more songs, and they didn't do an encore. The encore is normally, like Mickey singing I'm a Believer, and these days Nesmith singing Listen to the Band. And that was just part of the second half of the show. So they didn't do an encore, which I'm guessing is because it's hard for Nesmith to get around. So, so it took a lot longer of a show than I thought. But it's all good. I mean, so far it's been a great day, and I can't complain any, except for Dollar Tree. And, but that's about it. So, I may or may not, like I said, be making more videos on this. Otherwise, I will, edit this whole thing together and put it out, and maybe people will like it. So, once again, thanks, and, I'll talk to you soon.
Well, I tried to avoid it, but it was unavoidable. I had to make a pit stop on the way back on the opposite side of the freeway of the one that I used earlier. So, only have about an hour left, which is great. Had to make a pit stop, throw some water on my face. So, I'm going to go do that now. Pretty much the same style as the one on the other side of the freeway, just darker. Because it's night. So, never have a problem stopping off at these places. They're actually nice. So,
Pretty tired, though. All right. Oh, there we go. Once again, you cannot come in here.
I'm back in Vegas, baby. Back in Vegas.
Well, I made it home safely. It is 3:07 in the a.m. And the kitties seem mad at me because they didn't get their treats and stuff. But they'll get over it. And the trip back was fine. It was okay. Just tired. Very tired. And but otherwise, it was all right. Listened to Rob Zombie all the way out and could not do it on the way back. Just could not do it. Listened to a bunch of various artists that I downloaded. And then near the end, to keep me awake, listened to some Marilyn Manson. So that got me the rest of the way. So otherwise everything is good. So, farewell concert, chapter in my life, done. And now back here in Vegas and ready to start a whole new chapter doing something else. So, just wanted to do just a quick video, just let people know that I'm okay. Even though coming back this late, nothing bad happened. And, I guess that's really about it. So, I'll see how this all edits together. I'll start working on it tomorrow. And I'm going to go hop into the shower and then hit the hay. And then give the kitties some extra treats tomorrow. So I guess that's really about it. And so if you watch this, thank you. I really appreciate it. I hope you liked it. So, this is me, John Ward, signing off. Oh, look, there's a cat. Look. That's a Boris right there. So, I'll be signing off, and, I guess that's it. Yep, that's it. Now I'm rambling because I'm too tired. So, all right. Bye.